here in the North Mississippi Delta this morning in a planted sunflower field. It's early August. We're trying to capture and band some mourning doves. The reason we're doing this is tagging birds to release them into the population again that will be available for hunters to harvest potentially. A lot of the information that we get from these birds is information about their movements from where they were banded and released to where they're harvested. So when we're baiting a new area to attract doves, a lot of times what we'll do is put the bait out and leave the trap upside down next to it. So birds will come here, they'll see the bait, they'll feed in the area and get used to eating right next to the trap. But when we're ready to start trapping birds and actually start putting bands on, of course we'll place the trap over the bait. The birds have gotten used to coming here and feeding. They're comfortable with feeding. They'll land beside the trap and then figure out how to walk in the doors.
This is what we call a hatch year mourning dove. We're able to identify that by looking at the tips of the covert feathers. They've got that fringe on the tips of them. We don't identify the sex of a hatch year bird. We just call it unknown. Feather likely was just the molt feather that just came in. So from there, we'll count backwards the primaries, starting at 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. So this is gonna be the P2. It's gonna be the molt feather for this bird. We're gonna look. I always place the band on the right leg, so I'll pull out the right leg to see if I've already banded it, and I haven't. So we're gonna take the band and place it on the leg. Crimp it on good, kind of give it a twist. So from there, we've got the band on. We've got the information for the bird. Now we're just ready to release it.